Hi everyone. Today again I'm here to share my thoughts and ideas about how to be resilient and how to be passionate in one's dream to realize or to accomplish our goals and dreams. Everything in the world or everything you would like to achieve or you would like to accomplish and goals that you would like to reach are not as easy as you think. There are two primary choices in our life. Either we have to accept the things as they exist or take the responsibility to change them. You might have heard about the story of Albert Einstein, who was known for his intelligence, who was known for his perseverance and persistence in his work, whatever he did. It's not really easy. As some of our friends or some of us make us feel. Because there are so many hardships, step by step we have to follow, and so many struggles and ordeals we have to overcome. We have to get rid of the fear of failure, fear of rejection, fear of everything that holds us back. There are many things we need to keep in mind in order to get what we want in our life and what we want to achieve in our life. As somebody rightly said, adversity introduces a man to himself. That means when there is adversity, we will know ourselves because we have to find every now and then the means and ways to come out of such adversities. When adversities or bad luck or misfortune befall or strike us in our lives, we got to move forward no matter what. And we always have what it takes. We have potential. We just have to move with the power and conviction that we can achieve it. There are so many things in our life that are not smooth sailing. Everything in life will never happen on an even keel. It will never be easy. But just accepting those circumstances, all those problems or ordeals or all the setbacks, shortcomings, are the temporary inconveniences. They have come to pass not to stay with us forever. They are temporary. We just have to believe that we have unlimited potential. We have greatness within us to tackle or overcome any feeling of fear, feeling of uncertainty, feeling of powerlessness. But if we start with power and conviction, if we just begin with our belief that we can achieve it, it's always possible to achieve it. We got to be witty sometimes. We have to play hard with life when life knocks us down. Life will knock us down, but never knock us out. That's what we have to believe. The hardest thing in my life to believe was to believe that I was able to speak in public. I never spoke in public when I was a student. I always thought that I was overwhelmed by the fear of failure. Fear of facing the audience. But as and when I started doing so, I became successful. I got my best speaker award when I stepped into high school. That's how we got to be. The most important quality of a man to be resilient is to be humble. To be receptive and humble to any kinds of knowledge or learning is one of the best qualities that a man should inculcate in order to learn things very well and be resilient, to be free of fear. If we develop a sense of fragile ego, then we cannot learn anything else. We cannot learn any techniques or any strategies or anything else unless we believe in ourselves. We have to believe in ourselves and move forward. As I was narrating my story of my fear that held me back, that was always knocking me down, was my fear of speaking in public. I was not able to make speeches when I was in school. I was not able to face the public, not able to talk to the people. But as and when I started, one of my teachers told me that you have that potential. Do not make other people feel that you are inferior to them. Do not listen to people when they say you are not able to speak or when you are not able to do things. When they say you do not have ability, you do not have enough qualifications, or when you do not have things that are required or that are necessary for us, when humbleness is there, we can learn even from the people who are inferior to us, who are subordinate to us, and we can really gain knowledge. And if we feel that we have enough knowledge and we have enough experiences, and if we start comparing with those people who are inferior to us in terms of our hierarchical status, then that is not going to be a great thing to start. We got to get started with being humble to the people who are around us, and we can always attach or get connected to the power and potential we have with being humble to everyone. Even Albert Einstein, as I was talking in the beginning, that Albert Einstein was a very humble man. He was very learned, very knowledgeable, very well-educated and well-qualified person, but he was really humble. Even he did not mind to stay with his driver going from one place to another and seeking help and suggestions from his driver. And he was really a learned person, and everybody celebrates him, everybody honor him and respects him even today. Now, just to cite the example, how humble Albert Einstein was. Albert Einstein was teaching or imparting a knowledge of theory of relativity while he was going from one school to another. And he discovered that theory of relativity, and he invented that. He theorized that very important theory of relativity, and he was going from one place to another, teaching students from one school to another. And when he went to different schools, even driver was with him, and driver memorized everything, whatever was being said or imparted by Albert Einstein, because it was a repeated knowledge, a repeated lesson Albert Einstein taught to every school. And once it so happened that even driver was able to explain, because he mocked up or memorized everything. One day, driver said, "Okay, today I would like to explain the theory of relativity to one of the schools. And Albert Einstein, you should be my driver." And Albert Einstein was very happy with what driver said. And to his reply, Albert Einstein became very happy, because even the driver knew whatever he intended to impart to other students. And Albert Einstein agreed very readily, and he said, "Okay, today I'm going to be your driver. You'll be Albert Einstein for some time, as long as you teach in the class." And they went together, Albert Einstein being a driver, and in place of Albert Einstein was driver sitting comfortably beside Albert Einstein. Once they reached one of the schools where they wanted to impart their knowledge, and drivers started teaching students about the theory of relativity. And so happened, since driver memorized everything and he mocked up everything, perhaps without understanding, and one of the smart students from the classroom stood up and asked to the driver, "Hello, sir, can you once again explain the theory of relativity in the context of our day-to-day lives?" During that time, even driver was quite witty. He said, "Thank you so much for your question. The question is so easy that even my driver can answer." And luckily he was saved when Albert Einstein was there as his driver, and Albert Einstein stood up and started explaining. That's how he was saved. And this kind of humbleness, see, the kind of humbleness we see in Albert Einstein, in these narratives, what we can learn is that we can always be humble so that we'll learn. Had Albert Einstein been very egoistic and egocentric, he would never give chance to the driver to explain. At the same time, he would never explain when driver said that even his driver could answer. And even to this day, Albert Einstein is remembered for his prolific knowledge and ideas that he had imparted to the world. It is sinful to die before we make major contributions to the world, is what Les Brown said in his speech. And similarly, we can make many contributions to our knowledge, being humble. When we can impart knowledge to the world, that means we are contributing. That means we should live full and die empty. That means whenever we are alive, we got to be very, very active and sort the knowledge that befits us those are very important in our lives. It's not that knowledge is for ourselves only. We got to impart to others. We have to share with others so that others can also be knowledgeable. And together we can achieve such goals of educating everybody and making everyone knowledgeable and wisdomic in this world. And the part of being resilient or believing in ourselves is being humble and receiving everything else, and just to believing in ourselves that we have the capacity, we have the strength and sagacity to achieve anything and accomplish our dreams.